I'm TJ Manotok and this is your TFC News Now.
Let's begin in Louisiana, where over 1 million people still had no access to power on Monday morning after Hurricane Ida made landfall as a Category 4 storm near Port Fortune just before noon on Sunday with sustained winds of 150 miles per hour. Hundreds of thousands of people fled to safety upon Ida's arrival, which fell on the 16th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. Despite evacuation orders, Phil Am Loy Madrigal and his family stayed in New Orleans and just hunkered down in the second floor of their house.
We'll just hope for the best and see how much damage itong bagyo na to na si Ida.
Madrigal's son, Neil, assisted a news crew as Ida's wrath could be felt across the region.
We are getting hit left and right from heavy winds and water. We've had a whole bunch of buildings and other street signs and all that already destroyed by debris and houses already ripped apart.
In other news, President Joe Biden arrived at Dover Air Force Base in Delaware to honor 13 members of the U.S. military that were killed in a suicide bomb attack during the evacuation of civilians from Afghanistan last week. The Afghan affiliate of Islamic State has claimed responsibility for the deadliest attack on U.S. service members in Afghanistan in a decade. A Biden administration official says U.S. anti-missile defenses intercepted as many as 5 rockets that were fired at Kabul's airport early on Monday morning. There are less than 4,000 U.S. troops left at the airport, and Washington is set to complete its withdrawal from Afghanistan by Tuesday to meet a deadline agreed with the Taliban, which seized control earlier this month. This will put to end the 2 decades of U.S. military involvement there and also its longest war. And finally, the celebrations commemorating 75 years of U.S.-Philippine diplomatic relations continues at the Philippine Consulate General in Los Angeles.
This friendship has paved the way to a wide range of cooperation between the Philippines and the United States. To me, the most remarkable feature is the close cultural and people-to-people ties between the two countries.
As part of this month's festivities, the consulate is hosting an art exhibit mounted by the Philippine American Service Group Incorporated, or FASG, featuring a variety of local Filipino artists. During the event, the newly appointed Los Angeles Consul General even showed off his singing skills.
Ang iyong kamay, ang aking
hawa. And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube page. Stay with us, Kapamilya.
I'm Romel Quinclara, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with the aftermath of Hurricane Ida. Over the 80 million Americans living along the 1,200-mile stretch from Louisiana to Massachusetts could face major flood dangers from Ida this week as it moves northeastward. In Louisiana, over 1 million residents are still without power, leaving people with no access to air conditioning amid the sweltering heat. Ida was also blamed for at least 4 deaths in Louisiana and Mississippi. Experts have predicted up to $80 billion in damages for Ida, which made landfall as a Category 4 hurricane on the 16th anniversary of the devastating Hurricane Katrina.
Most areas have fallen trees and broken windows, broken doors, broken scaffolding, broken roofs, and a lot of trees have uprooted in these areas too.
This Phil Am, who works in security detail in New Orleans, says there are already cases of looting because of people's desperation. Let's go to Houston, Texas, where New Orleans resident Phil Am Crispin Pasilla and his family evacuated to just before the storm hit their hometown Sunday.
It's because of the experience we had the past 16 years. The Katrina, we were there and we didn't get out, so we know how hard to get out. But this time we get out, but it's still very hard because it took us 15 hours.
Pasilla says they heeded officials' warning to evacuate, but still worries about their home and his restaurant on Barone Street, just a mile south of Bourbon Street. His house was not flooded, but the roof of his restaurant was damaged. His biggest worry now is a power outage that officials have said could take days or weeks to restore.
Thank you, Richie. I can't wait to see you in Ottawa as our next MP from Mississauga, Streetsville.
And finally, in Canada, Prime Minister Justin Trudeau made a stop in the city of Mississauga on Friday to promote Liberal candidate Richie Valdez in the upcoming federal election on September 20th. Valdez, a Filipino-Canadian entrepreneur, feels honored to represent Filipinos and to be the voice for her riding of Mississauga, Streetsville.
This is my home. So I represent the people who live here. I've experienced everything that they've experienced. I'm a mother of two. I'm an entrepreneur. I opened my first business here. So I have the experiences and the knowledge of to understand what it's like to be their voice.
Valdez says her top priorities if elected would be healthcare, childcare, and affordable housing. And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC news on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Cup of Million.
I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
Let's begin with news in the aftermath of Hurricane Ida. 2 million Louisiana residents still have no access to power for the fourth day Wednesday, and authorities are rushing to set up cooling centers because of the sweltering heat. Officials are also urging people to stay away from their homes for now, but many of these residents are reportedly defying orders. For Louisiana Phil Am Gurley San Agustin, there was no question for her and her family to immediately evacuate to Texas.
Experiencing that, you know, the we felt the brunt of the storm, and you know, our neighboring subdivisions flooded. So I was already scared. From then on, I told my husband, you know, that any category, we are gonna go evacuate. I don't want to feel that brunt anymore. You know, the feeling of being scared.
New Orleans Mayor LaToya Cantrell has imposed a nighttime curfew to prevent crimes. Authorities say it could take months before affected areas to fully bounce back from Ida's wrath. Let's go to San Francisco, where some PhilAm business owners have mixed feelings about the city's mandate requiring proof of vaccination for all employees and customers of restaurants, gyms, bars, and entertainment venues.
In reality, it's a good rule. But for our business, I don't think it's really worked for that.
Diaz Guzman says her business has been barely getting by because of the shelter-in-place orders. That's on top of employers allowing their people to work from home and the general fear of COVID-19. Event planner Anthony Schlander, on the other hand, welcomes the new vaccine mandate.
I like the fact that I know I'm going somewhere and the venue is doing its absolute most to keep us healthy.
Mayor London Breed reports 80% of eligible San Franciscans are now vaccinated.
I am dog, and this makes me squirrel!
And finally, Pixar Animation Studios has a new series of 5 shorts featuring the hilarious adventures of lovable puppy Doug, voiced by Bob Peterson. It's been 12 years since Disney Pixar introduced Doug, along with characters Carl and Russell, in the award-winning movie Up.
I just love this character, and I love Carl Fredrickson, and I just wanted to get back with these characters.
The 5 episodes of Doug Days can be seen on Disney Plus.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews, and on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Cup of Media. I'm Henny Espinosa, and this is your TFC News Now.
Let's begin in the Northeast United States, where remnants of Hurricane Ida brought torrential rains and heavy flooding, which resulted in the deaths of at least 14 people. In New York and New Jersey, cars were swept, subway lines were submerged, and flights were temporarily grounded. In southern New Jersey, a powerful tornado destroyed several houses. Ida's wrath in the Northeast came 3 days after it struck Louisiana and parts of Mississippi, where about 1 million homes and businesses are still without power and more than 600,000 lack running water.
Yung mga organizations natin dito sa New Orleans, they are preparing and they are, they're all there kasi, alam mo, pag may mga ganitong nagre-reach out sila sa ibang lugar, tumutulong. So now it's hitting us. So they're trying to prepare. Ang problema lang ngayon is that hindi pa makapmobilize kasi nga wala pa tayong mga resources dito.
Let's meet PhilAm Sergeant G.S. War, who served 4 tours in Afghanistan from 2004 to 2010. Recent developments there, including America's withdrawal after 20 years, he told ABS-CBN News, brought many overwhelming memories to the forefront.
When I saw the pictures, it actually broke my heart because, again, I remembered those workers that I had before.
Eswar says despite some criticisms on how America's departure was executed, he agrees with President Joe Biden's decision.
Having lost some of my friends, who was also a service member, I mean, I think it's best for the country.
In 2 decades, 2,461 U.S. service members and civilians were killed, while more than 20,000 were injured. And finally, from Live Stage Productions, PhilAm Tony-winning Broadway producer Jet Tolentino is about to dabble in another entertainment platform, the big screen, as he makes his directorial debut. Asian Persuasion will be shot in New York in 2022 with an all-Asian cast starring PhilAm Hollywood actor Dante Basco, romantic comedy queen Tony Gonzaga, Broadway star Paolo Montalban, among many others.
Asian Persuasion is a story about an underachiever who just got divorced from his very successful fashion designer wife. But he just realized that he could not afford the alimony and child support. So he came up with this outlandish plot to marry her off to a suitor.
Tolentino says the film is more than 90% funded and is ready to be rolled out come 2022.
And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News. And on the ABS-CBN YouTube channel. Stay with us, Kappa Media.
I'm TJ Manotok and this is your TFC News Now.
Let's begin with remnants of Hurricane Ida now claiming the lives of at least 46 people after it pounded the Northeast with torrential rains and heavy floods. PhilAm Mikael Kaya walked through waist-deep flooded streets and then shot this video of a car with a passenger in it submerged in the Brooklyn-Queens Expressway.
There were people inside. I could not do anything. They didn't want to leave their car.
In Rockland County, New York, half of Little John Gadya's backyard was flooded in up to 3 feet of water from a creek that overflowed.
This one was nonstop. It started like 5:30 in the afternoon. It ended up like 1:30 in the morning.
Meanwhile, in Jersey City, New Jersey, Trixie Ava's basement got flooded and ruined her balikbayan boxes, scheduled to be sent home to the Philippines this Christmas. The Biden administration has pledged to assist states devastated by Ida. Over in Los Angeles, where the Philippine Consulate is hoping a third-party service provider can help ease up the backlog caused by the pandemic. The consulate is opening a Philippine Passport Renewal Center operated by VFS Global.
What we have done is to add the VFS Global to our range of services so that you will have the option. Whether you still want to go through the appointment system of the consulate using the global appointment system, or you'd rather go to VFS Global. Except that, as I mentioned earlier, you will be paying a certain markup fee.
Working under the Philippine government supervision, VFS will only process simple passport renewals. VFS will also give clients a chance to track their progress of their applications. As a third-party provider, their services do come with an extra $52 service fee on top of the $60 Philippine passport cost.
Throughout my life, the Ten Rings gave our family power.
And finally, in entertainment news, Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings is delivering its action scenes in a big way. Its lead star, Simu Liu, took on the Marvel superhero mantle with ease with a touch of comedy.
What happened to your shirt?
To have a scene partner like Nora, who also comes from a very comedic background and is able to just kind of go there with you, it just resulted in a lot of improv.
In directing Shang-Chi, Japanese-Hawaiian director Destin Daniel Cretton says it's important to show an Asian superhero story on the big screen.
You can't run from your past.
Shang-Chi and the Legend of the Ten Rings also features Asian superstars Michelle Yeoh and Tony Leung. And those are the news making headlines today. Catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube page. Stay with us, Kapamilya.